Very pleased to say I'm joined by Akib Fiaz. Good to see you, mate.
Good to see you too. How are you doing, Chris? You all right?
Very well. Like a hard session there today, punching that medicine ball into each other's stomachs. It looked painful.
Yeah. It's been an hard week, to be fair. Friday today, so good little last session tomorrow and then rest for a day and a half. So yeah, ready for next week. More hard work.
Good news for you has just come last week. You heard you're going to be fighting on the new Matchroom shows in the Garden.
Yeah.
This new fight camp series that they've got coming up. So August, you're back in the ring. It's August been a while 7th, now. Yeah. It feels. Cain Barker was your last fight.
Yeah.
So all systems go again for you in
training. Yeah. Well, I mean, it's been all systems go anyway all the way through. To be fair, I've stayed in the gym. Stayed. You know, somewhat fit and somewhat ready, just in case. And yeah, obviously my opportunity's come now, August again. It's been a while, like he says. I think by the time we get in the ring, it'll be like 9-10 months since my last fight. But, you know, good thing is that I've been in the gym, staying active, staying ready, getting loads of sparring in, good sparring as well. So yeah, I'll be more than ready.
Yeah. You was busy, wasn't you, up until that? You was having regular fights.
Yeah.
I was speaking to your teammate there as well, Stephen and Sean. They were saying the same thing. They've had time to really knuckle down and train hard, and it's one thing they've kept in the gym.
And the thing is, because you've not got fights coming up, you can sort of work on things that sometimes you neglect because you're always trying to get fit, get your weight down, be ready for the fight, do the rounds and stuff. Whereas because we've not had any of that, it's just been working on different aspects of our games. And I feel like we've all improved because we've been doing a lot of tech sparring as well with each other and stuff as well. So instead of always hard sparring and hard graft, we've been doing a lot of tech stuff as well. So I think we've all improved, yeah. It's been good for us all.
I mean, that's right as well. The fighters in this gym are all quality. I mean, Chantel's just won a world title. I know you were sparring with her for that. We'll talk about that in a minute. But you've got Jack Cattrall there on the verge of big things. You've Carl Frampton was a mainstay in here. And you know, we can go around them all, but you've got some quality fighters in this gym to be learning off, and I'm sure you have been doing that as well as you know, two great coaches. And
yeah, like you say, I feel like it's my job to be learning off not just the fighters, off of the coaches as well, but not just because of the fact that I'm the youngest out of everyone and stuff, and I'm early on in my career. I feel like it's your job anyway as a boxer to be learning all the time and adding to your game. I feel like when you stop, that's you know, when you should really retire, I think. But I like you say, Jack Cattrall, do loads of sparring with him. Carl used to do loads with him. Chantel, you know, these are all top fighters. Even the other fighters, you know, Martin Murray, he comes in, does some pads in that with us now and then. Tommy Coyle, you know, they all come in and give a little bit of advice and stuff. For me, it's great because it's like getting it first hand off people that have been and done it all. So I know what they're saying is true and it's right. Do you know what I mean? So it's perfect, and I feel like I've improved so much. You know, I've been here for 2.5 years now, and I'm a different fighter, I think.
I mean, anyone who knows you've got loads of talent. And you've been showing that as well. You know, this fight now, is it just about getting back in the ring, isn't it? This next one, the next couple of fights, hopefully. But you're back on that big stage again. People are starting to know your name and starting to see that, you know, what it's all about and what Akib's all about. So
yeah, well,
you're just waiting to really springboard from it.
Yeah, I think fight camp, the slogan is no easy fights, isn't it? So, you know, it won't be just a case of getting back in the ring, you know. It's going to be someone who's coming to win and coming to, you know, cause an upset. So, but I feel like them sort of fights I've had anyway coming through, and I'm sort of ready for them, like, you know, a little bit earlier than what I should have been. But because of the pandemic and stuff, you know, it's out of everyone's hands really, isn't it? We've got to do what's got to be done. You know, everyone wants to move a little bit faster than usual. I mean, like, I'm in no rush really. I'm only young, but you know, it's whoever they put in front of me. Do you know what I mean? I don't mind really. It's my job. Like, I've got the best team in the world. You know, Jamie, Steve Wood, Eddie, and Frank Smith, and the guys. They pick the opponents, and it's up to me to do, you know, what Jamie says and go and get the win.
You're patient.
Yeah, that's
follow
it.
The process,
yeah. Exactly. Yeah, follow the process, like you said. You know, there's too many fighters these days. Like, you know, go 15-20 and all fighting no one and don't really do anything. They're pro for 5 or 6 years and no one's heard the name. Whereas, you know, I don't want a padded record really. Do you know what I mean? So yeah. What have been learning fights all the way through.
I think that's one thing it has done as well, that this break, there is competitive fights coming now, and these matches are being made and people are taking fights, proper fights as well. Is there, I mean, there's obviously no names and stuff like that, but is that you maybe can announce yet? But is there a list of fighters who might be on that list who you've been looking at or they put to you?
Well, I've not really looked at anyone. I think obviously Steve's going through them all and Jamie. I don't really get much of a say in it. And I don't think I should really. I don't think fighters need to. You know, it's up to your teams really. You know, if they can come to agreements and stuff and get the fight sorted, and if it's the right fight, it's the right fight, isn't it? And then I do my job and that's in the ring, do you know what I mean? All the other stuff outside, that's not really my job.
Have you looked at the card as well, who's on it?
Well, two guys I've sparred really. It's Kid Galahad and Jazz Dickens fighting for the world title. Yeah, I've sparred both of them guys. I've done a bit of sparring with Jazz in here. Sparred Kid Galahad when I was an amateur. Good fight, and as a fan really, I'm going to love it. Love to just sit there and watch him and learn off them both, because you know, like I say, they're both accomplished fighters. They boxed before, so you know, it's good to see how they'll deal with that. They're friends, aren't they, outside the ring, but I think inside the ring on the night, it's going to be a great, great fight to watch as well.
Yeah, looking forward to that one. Forward to it, it'll be a good feel. And they're regular as well, them, aren't they? They're on every week, so it's...
Yes, I think it's 3 weeks back-to-back, isn't it? And all 3 weeks, they're really good fights, and I think the week after is Boatsy and Blotnicks, you know, so that's a good fight as well.
Yeah.
And I'm sure the card will be just as good as well.
What's your gym mate, Mark Leach, British title eliminator win last week, wasn't it? Thomas Asamba. That was another good win for the gym. He's on the verge of some big things as well. That was a good one. Yeah. He was all over there supporting him.
Mark's a great fighter. Like you say, he's just not really had the opportunities. I think he's 14, 15 fights in now. I think now's the time where he's got that opportunity to, you know, change his life really. And I really in the past I felt sorry for him because he's got the talent. He's got all the ability in the world, Mark. And he's in the gym and stuff, and he, you know, he's just waiting for this chance. And I think now he's got it. And now's the time for everyone to see him. Obviously, he had a good win last time against Kez Ashfaq as well. That was a good fight between them both. And this time against Asamba, that was another good win. He makes it look sort of easy, doesn't he, Mark? All the time, he's just so good and moving his head and being all evasive. And he sort of just breaks your heart before, you know, like without even hitting you. He's a really good fighter, and I think. I remember Mark from the amateurs watching him. I must have been about 11, 12, second year in the school boys. Used to watch him and everyone used to be like, wow. Everyone used to crowd around the ring to watch him. That's how talented he was. And, you know, it's finally, you know, he's getting his chance on the big stages and stuff. So, yeah. Wish him all the luck in the world.
Definitely. He's a quiet lad, isn't he? He's just like, his boxing's doing the talking.
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
Whatever he was. And you was, you know, you could say chief sparring partner for a world champion in Chantel Cameron for a world title white in the first defence a few weeks back now, was it? A couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
Again, another great success story from the gym. And she's some fighter, isn't she?
Chantel.
Great style. I'm a big fan, yeah.
Yeah, I think they're going to love her over in America. Mm. She's got that sort of Mexican style. She comes forward, she's aggressive, throws loads of punches. I think her and Katie Taylor's a really good, really, really good fight, you know. Obviously, Katie's a great, she's an all-time great for the women's boxing, but in my opinion, Chantel's got all the tools in a locker to beat her, because you've seen Pasoon cause her a lot of trouble with the pressure and that sort of come-forward style, and I feel like Chantel's got that, but a lot more, so it'll be an harder fight for Katie, I think, yeah.
How was the sparring? What was it like sparring with
Chantel? Yeah, I know. Everyone thinks, oh, it's a woman and stuff, and... But she comes and she's nasty, Chantel. She comes at you with 100 shots around, non-stop pressure all the time. And because it's 2 minutes as well, it's a lot faster pace than the 3 minute rounds that the men do. And I think Chantel's one of them fighters that if it was 3 minutes, it'd be easy for her because all the other women wouldn't be able to keep up with her. And it's hard sparring with her. It's because she gives as good as she gets and she keeps coming, do you know what I mean? So it's hard to stop her.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that fallacy of you can't hit a woman back in the ring now. You're defending yourself.
You've got to hit her, yeah.
But yeah, it was great to see her win that wheel tight and bring it back to the gym. Do you miss sparring Carl Frampton now he's hung up his gloves? Because that was some experience for you as well.
That was a great experience for me. Not even just sparring him, just being around him. But seeing the kind of, you know, the way he is and the way he structures his camps and everything like that, it was great. He was in actually 2 days ago. He come over to see Jamie and that, seen him. Good to see him. But like you say, you know, everyone has their time. Everyone has their time. Everyone has their careers, and he's done a lot. Do you know what I mean? He's paid his dues in boxing, and he's got deservedly what he deserves. Do you know what I mean? He accomplished a lot of things, and all through hard work and dedication and sacrifices. You know, years and years of it. I remember like him. being over here, ringing his kids and his wife and stuff, and it was hard to see, like, because you know that he's missing him and it's hard, but he knew what, in the back of his mind, he knew what he was doing it for, and so did they, but it's the sacrifices, isn't it, like you say, and years of them, and they paid off, I think, for him.
Yeah, and you've seen that, and our world champion goals about his camp and...
Yeah, exactly. And I don't even think Carl was like a world level sort of fighter. I think he was a little bit past that, because he didn't just have a world title and like lose it, did he? He won world titles, he unified divisions, won world titles in two divisions, and then he tried for the third division as well, which is a big, big thing, do you know what I mean? And obviously he was just a little bit, you know, fell short on the night. But like you say, he's had a great, great career in the past anyway, so... You know, it was the right time for him to go, and he told us anyway before the fight, he said, like, I'm retiring after this anyway, so I think he wanted to just go out on a high, but obviously, you know, it's not that easy, is it, sometimes, but I think he had a great career and one that he should be proud of.
Oh, again, Jack in the gym, he's probably been here a couple of years now, has he? That's been a great addition to the gym and a great addition to your camp and someone else world level to train.
Jack was out in Vegas with us as well, actually, sparring and stuff there with me, with other fighters and stuff going around. Jack's a top fighter.
You spar a lot with Jack as well?
Yeah, spar a lot with Jack. Learn loads off Jack as well, still learning loads off Jack, because he's got that sort of defensive style that I never used to really have in the locker. I was always come forward, pressure, and couldn't really defend, whereas Jack's all defensive. So we sort of learn off each other, really, but I've learned so much of Jack and defence and just being calm and sort of having that patience. But again, I feel like Josh Taylor is probably one of the hardest fights Jack could have got for the world title. If you look at the past, you know, champions, WBO champions, Hooker and the rest of them guys, probably the hardest fight is Josh Taylor. But I feel like because of how hard that fight is on paper, I feel like Jack will be better in himself and it'll bring out the best in Jack as well, and you'll see a good performance. And if he pulls off the game plan and what Jamie's talking about, he beats Josh, but it's like you say, on the night, isn't it? A lot of things come into, you know, in Scotland and all the pressure, but I think he's got all the tools to beat him and it'll bring out the best in him.
Yous will be supporting him. A great fight for British boxing.
Yeah, listen, if it's just us against the whole of Scotland, we can't wait. Do you know what I mean? We're there.
No, it's great to catch up with you, Akib.
Yeah, no, thanks.
And you know, see everyone in the gym today, and that we'll do it again soon when you know before you fight, once you're in full training. I suppose the real stuff starts now, does it? Getting the real big long runs and the pain.
That's so. Loads of hard sparring, loads of hard, you know. This week actually has been very, very hard. The first week's always the hardest, really. The first and the last, in between, it's you're sort of in the middle, aren't you? But the first week, because your training just been taking over, really, and then you pick it up, and then your body's aching and it's tired, and you know you're broken, really. That's what training is, isn't it? You're breaking your body down, and then you've got to go again the next day, and then the next day, sometimes two or three times in a day. So it's really good, but you know it'll all be worth it.
Yeah, you can go home and rest now. Is there anyone you want to? Thank
I just want to say a massive thank you to all my sponsors. Like you say, it's been hard like the last 10 months, you know, with no fight dates, no nothing coming up, but my sponsors have been backing me all the way through, making it possible for me to be in the gym working hard and, like you say, learning and improving my game all the time. So thank you to them guys.
Brilliant.
Cheers.
Catch you soon.
Nice one, Chris.
God bless.